Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me today is Rob Roscow from Mydecine Innovations Group. Rob, good to see you. How are you?
Great. It's great to be here and talking to you, Christine.
Rob, lots to get to today. Lots of patent news we've been seeing from the company. Tell us about this kind of first set of news. Have you filed your patent application to cover multiple families of psilocybin analogs?
Absolutely. And so really this filing is exciting for Mydecine because it really highlights the two families of novel molecule work that we've been doing, really iterating off of psilocybin as a starting point, or more precisely psilocin, its active metabolite. So when you think of people taking psilocybin, it's actually psilocin that they're actually experiencing as the active component. And so what we've been doing there is really tackling two drug properties that are inherent in this filing. And the first is we're very interested in controlling the delivery of psilocin to better control the time course of overall effect. The more precisely we can deliver the drug, the more we can control that. And we can also remove some inherent variability person to person in GI metabolism. And so what we've done there is made a category of psilocin analogs that are dermally permeable. And so we've modified these in such a way that they will transit through the skin, which is a property that both psilocybin and psilocin as they stand in nature do not have. And so it's not possible to make a dermally delivered psilocin. And we're very interested in this because the most precise way of delivering a drug is obviously intravenous or injectable delivery, but we don't feel as a company this is really matched well for a mental health setting. So we can provide basically the exact same benefits in a transdermal solution. And so this is what the first set of technical features in the filing is related to. Secondly, if you think of psilocin as your active metabolite, the drug of interest for research, it's actually, as it sits in nature, not very stable. So if you make a tablet of this and put it on a pharmacy shelf, it's losing potency day over day over day. And this is not really a workable solution for a medication that a physician or a therapist needs to rely on being exactly what they expect. And so we've also directly addressed this technical property, which we believe the two of these in combination will result in a shelf-stable, dermally delivered, very precise time course psilocin-like product. And so we're very excited about that as a long-term research goal.
And does that include the patent that you're filing to use nanoemulsion technology for the drug as well, or is that separate?
So these are actually two separate technologies, but they're following the same theme of being able to precisely or in an enhanced way deliver the active drug. And so with a nanoemulsion, what we're doing is really encapsulating the drug of interest, the medicine of interest, so that it's more bioavailable, less of it gets destroyed in the gut, et cetera. And so this is what we're focusing on, not only for just psilocybin, but a number of other very popular medicinal components that are made in fungi that are commonly used in over-the-counter supplements, such as cordyceps and reishi. And so we're really excited about this as a simple, food-safe way of delivering the same compounds that we're interested in more efficiently.
So as you kind of shore up your patent portfolio here, in terms of actually kicking off some of these clinical trials next year, what should we expect?
So next year is going to be a really exciting year. We have two core clinical trial programs going right now. So we have a partnership with Johns Hopkins and specifically Dr. Matt Johnson looking at really taking the work that's been so exciting that he's done around smoking cessation and nicotine addiction with psilocybin and therapy and moving that into a regulatory facing clinical trial. And so we'll see patients being seen in this clinical trial program next year, which we're very excited about. And then secondly, we also have a multi-site PTSD clinical trial program spearheaded by our chief medical officer, Dr. Rakesh Jetley. And so we've been working across all of our sites and cohort to launch this early next year. And so we're very excited to be getting that going across multiple countries and multiple sites. So really exciting for us next year with the clinical trials.
We'll look forward to it. Rob, good to have you on again. Thanks so much for the time.
Absolutely. Thank you, Christine.